Live.BYULacrosse.com. Test, test.
Yeah, I know it. So does he.
Great. He's got mad now.
Okay, we're good. Go ahead.
Whenever you're ready.
You ready to go?
Yep.
You ready? Do it, TC! Let's do it, TC! Get a start, Tom!
Well, good afternoon. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to North University Field on the campus of Brigham Young University. To begin our activity here this afternoon, we'd first like to welcome the University of Nevada Reno men's lacrosse team here to campus. I assume this is part of their spring break. We appreciate you guys coming down. Best of luck to you in today's game. As is our tenant here at Brigham Young University, we begin each of our on-campus activities with an opening prayer. Our prayer will be offered by Chase Miller, a senior from Alamo, California, and a member of the BYU men's lacrosse team. Chris. Now, ladies and gentlemen, honor America, please rise for the singing of our national anthem. Our anthem will be sung this afternoon by Taya Westcott, who is 13 years old from Kaysville, Utah. Taya, come forward, please. Again, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to North University Fields on the campus of Brigham Young University for MCLA men's lacrosse. Now introducing the starting lineup for the UNR Wolfpack. On attack for the Wolfpack, a 6'1", 185-pound senior from California High School in San Ramon, California, number 31, Eric Ledbetter. A 6'0", 165-pound sophomore from Granada High School in Livermore, California, number 18, Tanner Kristoff. 5'11", 170-pound freshman from Casa Grande High School in Petaluma, California, number 11, Thomas Rickaroo. At the midfield, the 6'0", 180-pound sophomore from Bellarmine College Prep in San Jose, California, number 20, Tyler Meekin. The 5'9", 160-pound freshman from Greenwood High School in Tulsa, California, number 8, Chase Browning. The 5'9", 185-pound freshman from West C&T Academy in Las Vegas, Nevada, number 8, Ryan Munoz. At long stick mini, a 6'2", 180-pound senior from Livermore High School, Livermore, California, number 47, Brandon Hall. On the defense, a 6'4", 185-pound junior from Monterey High School in Monterey, California, number 17, Cedric Hoey. A 6'2", 190-pound sophomore from Centennial High School in Las Vegas, Nevada, number 26, Drake Stewart. A 5'11", 205-pound freshman from Sutter High School in Yuba City, California, number 12, Tristan Freeman. And in the goal, the senior, 6'0", 245 from Bishop O'Dowd High School in Castro Valley, California, number one, Eddie Connolly. The head coach of Wolfpack is Chris Petro in his sixth season out of Portland. Ryan, assisted by Ryan Baldani out of Denver and Matt Carroll out of UMass. Now introducing the starting lineup for your number four ranked Brigham Young University Cougars. On attack for the Cougars, a 6'3", 210-pound junior from Casco High School in Casco, Minnesota, number 23, Tanner Johnson. A 5'9", 170-pound sophomore in Tippecanoe High School in Orem, Utah, number 2, Winston Farley. A 5'9", 175-pound sophomore at Acorda Canyon High School in Draper, Utah, number 25, Harry Watts. And the midfield, a 6'4", 190-pound junior at Libertyville High School in Libertyville, Illinois, number 17, Zach Labrum. A 5'7", 165-pound sophomore at Bingham High School in South Jordan, Utah, number 8, Chris Feverson. A 5'8", 165-pound sophomore, a transfer from Marquette University from Booker, Iowa, Washington, 5, Connor Bernal. At Long Stick Mitty, a 6'1", 190-pound senior at Woodbridge High School in Irvine, California, number 4, Max Messer. On the defense, a 6'1", 190-pound senior from West Forest, Mendham High School in Mendham, New Jersey. Number 33, Harrison Wardle. A 6'0", 190-pound senior from Rochester Adams High School in Rochester, Michigan, number 26, Devin Neves. A 6'3", 225-pound junior out of Alpha High School in Draper, Utah, number 18, Boston Hanley. And in the goal, a 6'0", 180-pound freshman from Allen High School in Frisco, Texas, number 1, Mason Moon. The head coach of BYU Cougars is Matt Schneck, his 8th season BYU 97, assisted by Marty Westcott, Jordan Harris, Elliot Grove, Taylor Red, Mark Stout, Carol Moore is the strength and conditioning coach. The head trainer is Chelsea Clayton.
And Taylor Red, yeah!
Well, all right, here we are, everybody. We're live in Provo, Utah, and the weather is absolutely terrible. It is 40 degrees. We're all freezing, but that's okay. We're going to play lacrosse, and the Cougars will start with the ball.
Nice play, Max.
Here are the starting lineups for today's game. The big change that you'll see here is number 25, Harry Wadups, will be playing the attack position. Wadups now leads the Cougars with 22 points on the board. They wanted to move Chris Severson out to the midfield, the coaching staff wanting to have a Dodger up top, and Chris fits the bill like that. Of course, the UNR is led by their goalie, number one, Eddie Conley, the senior.
Who was that shot by?
Tanner Johnson,
23.
UNR is clearing. Mackin, number 20, does a good job for UNR and clearing the ball, and they'll start at their own restraining line. Mackin with the ball now. Dodging through. Gets away. Shot. And it's a save by Mason Moon. And a crease violation, so the ball will go back to BYU, and they will be clearing. Harrison Warnell, the All-American, with the ball now to Mason Moon. the goalie as we move the ball up on the clear, and Max Nesser in possession gets it behind to Wadups. Cougars will start moving the ball around now. Now goal line extended with Wadups as BYU makes a line change here. Andrew Bertha now with the ball. And Max Nesser will now leave the field, and we'll bring out Dallin Bentley, the Gatorade National Athlete of the Year, not lacrosse player, Athlete of the Year out of Bingham High School. And Bentley now with the ball. Starts his dodge, circles back to Bertha. Bertha now to Yost, and nice shot on goal by Tanner Johnson. It looks like the goalie did get a piece of it, and UNR will be clearing. UNR with the ball at the midfield line, looking for an attackman, gets it to a midi. And they will settle and set up their offense. Shot by number five, it's wide. Mason Moon looks like he got a piece of it, but and he did, and the ball will go to the Cougars as they start their clear. Up to Johnson now. Johnson back into Connor Bernal, a transfer from Marquette. And out of Wadups. Severson now at the midfield. As I mentioned a little bit earlier, they've got Chris now up at the midfield. Coaches wanted another initiator, another distributor back up at the top. And Chris Severson seems to be much more effective dodging from the restraining line than from behind the cage. So that's a big positive for the Cougars. Bernal with the toe dip gets it behind. Ball goes down to Johnson. Gets it back up though. It has stopped raining for now. Hopefully that'll remain the way through the rest of the game. As Bernal retreats back to Severson. Now over to Zach Labrum. And Bernal's clear. Oh, he just can't get the shot off though. He gets tipped at the very end there and ball goes over the goal. But the Cougars retain possession. Shot by Johnson, shot is wide. Didn't quite get his stick around. And ball goes back up top to Wadups. So the Cougars will rerun their offensive set here as Winston Farley comes around looking for Bernal up top. Ball's at X now with Wadups. Wadups is clear. Shot, goal. So that's a nice first effort there by Harry Wadups on the assist from Connor Bernal. Wadups, as I mentioned earlier, now the leading scorer for the Cougars now with 23 points on the season. Tanner Johnson earlier in the season was getting the best defender usually from the opposing team. And that's absolutely allowed Wadups now to kind of move into better scoring positions on the field and capitalizes on that one. Connor Williams with the ball, one-time face. He's going to look down, shoot, and that's wide. Just slightly wide on that shot on the face-off, but Cougars retain possession. Max Nesser with the ball. And Michael Perry is out. Michael Perry was injured against Simon Frazier, and he's back out there on attack now, number 19. And you'll see him initiate from behind. Very effective dodger from behind. Number 19, Michael Perry. Second line is out now with Andrew Bertha. Number 7 passes into number 22. And shot and score. So that's a nice give and go there for the Cougars. As number 22, Josh Tunick, scores for the Cougars on the assist from Andrew Bertha. Felipe DeVarney, number 25, is facing off for UNR with Connor Williams now for the Cougars. And that's a nice pickup for Connor Williams. He'll look downfield. He'll get it to Chase Miller, the fastest player on the team, as demonstrated right there. He's got his stick free, shoots. Oh, and just wide. Nice effort there by Chase Miller. Cougars still retain possession as Chase Miller comes off. And Chris Severson goes back on for the Cougars. Severson with the ball to Labrum. And back to Connor Bernal. Bernal at the restraining line. He'll move it again to Labrum. Labrum with the ball now passed to Michael Perry behind. Cougars trying to give everybody a touch before they initiate. And the ball goes behind at X to Michael Perry. And here's Michael Perry. This is where he's most effective in dodging from behind at X. He's doubled. Ball goes into Labrum. Left-hand shot and goes over the top of the goal. Labrum could just not get quick control of that left-handed shot in time to get a good shot off. But Cougars retain possession. What ups? Oh, and a beautiful shot. You saw that in the camera, I hope. Beautiful shot by Chris Severson on the assist. So our score here, is it 2 or 1 to nothing? And that ball is going to go back over to the Wolfpack as they start their offensive set now. UNR getting their midfield on the field now. They're ready to go. Good D by Wardle. Ball goes down. And BYU will recover as Devin Needs picks that up in the crease. And up to Max Nesser. Max Nesser, the All-American out of Irvine, California, now with the ball. He'll not afraid to shoot that, but he'll pass it off on this one. And now the ball gets over to Michael Perry. Dallin Bentley up top now with the ball. Bentley starting to see additional playing time now that Chris Severson has moved up to the midfield. And Bertha now at the restraining line. Looks for Bentley. Bentley will initiate from there. Gets a step, shot, and goalie save by UNR. That's a nice save by Eddie Conley. And UNR now will start their clear. It's an errant pass that goes through. Pops up to number 24, who's got it now. And he'll settle it down now for UNR, and they'll start their offense. Flag down on the play. The BYU coaches issuing a call back to the officials, and they are going to call that as an offsides. So it'll be a 30-second penalty on the Cougars. UNR will be man up for 30 seconds.
Where is it? So what happened? How do we get the ball back?
Hey, Jake, over here. Jake, over here, in the box. You go in at 0-2.
A shot by number 55. The shot is wide. And the Wolfpack will retain possession.
Hey, 402? Yeah. Hey. 402. Hey, 402. 402.
Shot by 31, and kind of hits a Ricky Rose's stick, a BYU defender, and BYU has possession. It's struggling there in the corner now. And the ball goes cross field now to Devin Needs, and Needs will bring it up for the Cougars. Cougars still man down. And the penalty is now released, and it's all even with Wadups with the ball. Back to X to Tanner Johnson. Now to Perry. Perry's seeing some time on attack now for BYU. And BYU now has the first midfield line on the field. And Bernard will initiate it by getting over to Wattups behind. So 23 Tanner Johnson with the ball as the Cougars start their rotation on offense. Labrum dodging, steps away, gets it to Johnson in the crease. Oh, and a nice crease pass, but unfortunately Bernal could not get his stick on it. And UNR will pick that up and try to clear it out. Long stick is forced back, and that's an errant pass, and that's going to be Cougar ball. Tanner Johnson picks it up immediately, looks in the crease, shot and score. Nice, quick whistle on that by Tanner Johnson. Thinking quick on that. And Michael Perry, number 19, finishes for the Cougars. Hey, we want to let you know about our BYU team store, which is open. Now, this is usually just for the players, but because you're watching on YouTube here this evening, you'll get a chance to order right from the website where the players get all their gear from, so take advantage of that. The flag down now. That's going to be on UNR. As BYU gets their second midfield on. Spencer Tunick now out there with the second line, as well as Dallin Bentley. Up to Bentley. He'll work from the restraining line. As Bertha sets the pick, he'll work through. Stick is clear, but he'll take it behind. Dallin Bentley now at X. Starts to dodge, turns. And the ball, I believe, hit the defender and is on the ground now. The long stick for UNR picks that up, and then we'll get a whistle. And this will be a man-up opportunity for the Cougars. So UNR picks up the penalty as a slash on number 38. It'll be a 1 minute personal foul. BYU would be man up for 1 minute.
I'll count it down.
As the BYU man up unit now initiates.
Okay, all right, thank you.
So it's out at 30.
30.
Connor Burnell. Back to Severson. Shot by Harry Wadups, and that's wide. Harry Wadups, a pretty accurate shooter. He's usually right on target with that sidearm there, but missed that one. Michael Perry brings it up to Severson. Shot and score. So that's going to be a Michael Perry assist up to Chris Severson, the MCLA All-American out of Bingham High School in Salt Lake City.
Who's the assist?
Michael Perry. Michael Perry, 19.
Connor Williams with the successful clear off, successful face off, I should say, for the Cougars. And he'll come out. They'll get second midfield back on as defensive midfielder Chase Miller comes off into Bentley. Bentley back to Bertha. Bertha back to Bentley. And Michael Perry now at X for the Cougars.
Seconds.
Bertha going to initiate from up top, turns back over to Josh Tunick now. Tunick trying to bring it down the line, gets it behind. And up top to Bertha, and Boother take this shot, and that goes right in. Boy, that's a laser from Andrew Bertha. You could have hung your wash on that one. And the Cougars will take a 6-0 lead here now over the Wolfpack of University of Nevada at Reno. Yes. 44 Connor Williams now facing off for the Cougars. Number 25, Felipe DeVarani for UNR. And that's the end of the first quarter of play with our score, BYU 6, Nevada 0. And we'll be right back with you.
You can be the greatest, you can be the best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest.
You can be a master, don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you go find yourself.
Standing in the Hall of Fame. The world's gonna know your name.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Cause you're playing with the brass ring.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And the world's gonna know your name.
Be students, be teachers. Be politicians, be preachers.
Be preachers.
Yeah. Be believers, be leaders. Be astronauts, be champions.
Standing in the hall.
BYU is always going to be in my heart. I didn't just come through BYU. BYU went through me.
So we will start the second period of play here now with number 29, Tanner Bean, facing off for the Cougars. Felipe De Vieri facing off for UNR. Chase Miller's got a beat on it. He picks it up on the one-time scoop. And he'll get it back in the middle to Nesser. Nesser looks inside. Gets it to Winston Farley, but he decides to come back through. And Nesser will come off now as the BYU first midfield will enter play. up top to Bernal with the fake, shot, and goal. An assisted goal for Connor Bernal on a nice pass from well behind X. And Connor Bernal does the stop fake, dodges through, and finishes strong. So Bean will face off again for the Cougars. I believe that's 16 facing off for UNR. It's Enrique Diaz. And Tanner Bean should scoop through this and gain possession for the Cougars. Tanner Johnson now goes behind the cage, now at X. And up to Winston Farley. And Tanner Johnson up top to number five, Bernal, but it was over his head, and it's going to go out of bounds. That's going to be UNR ball. Turnover by the Cougars. Christian Freeman with the ball for UNR. Back to the goalie. They'll start their clear to the middle of the field there. And the attack is going to try to push him back. And they get the ball away from him. And 19, Michael Perry's got it. But they're going to do a slow break on this one as they didn't quite have the numbers to go to the goal. Perry take it behind now to Winston Farley. Zach Layman with the ball behind X to Winston Farley. Farley up top to Johnson. And here's Michael Perry now at X. He's going to put the rocket jets on and see if he can get around. Gets it back up to Bernal. Bernal steps in, shot, and that goes over the top of the goal. Looked like it had a beat on the upper left-hand corner, but goes high. Zach Labrum. Labrum, the midfielder, circling behind, gets through, gets a stick free and shot and score. Nice dodge from behind by Zach Labrum. These three midfielders on the BYU first midfield line can all dodge. And when they have an opportunity on the exchange with the attackman, when they're behind, they are given instructions to go. And Zach Labrum successful on that dodge from behind. 29 Tanner Bean still out there for the Cougars. Bean had a nice game against Simon Frazier at the faceoff X, and Coach Schneck has given him an opportunity to go back out there. UNR on this faceoff does get possession. And he's double-teamed there. Ball is dropped, but the coach for UNR, Chris Tetro, out of SUNY Cortland, gets the timeout just before he loses the ball. We'll take a break. We'll be right back with you.
The Cougar lies in wait, ready to spring. One moment, calm, reposed. The next, dialed in. A single focus, a single mind, to come away with the prize. So is the life of a Cougar. Ever on alert, always on the prowl. We are Cougar Nation, seizing the day.
All right, it's Tom Campbell right back with you now. As coming out of the timeout now, UNR will start their offensive set. The Wolfpack needs to take some time here and play a little offense, hopefully get the ball out to everybody so they can get a touch on this, get into the game. And that's going to be a flag on the Cougars. And presupposing that that's going to be a push, and it is a push, 30-second technical foul on the Cougars. So BYU or BYU will be on the defense here, man down, for 30 seconds as UNR has a man-up opportunity here. Good rotation. Oh, boy. And that'll put another gray hair on the head of Chris Tetro, head coach of UNR, as the skip pass is completely missed there by UNR. And the Cougars will clear, and the penalty is over. Dallin Bentley now with the ball for the Cougars. Gets it over to Johnson. And back at X now to Winston Farley. Cougars getting the ball around. They usually don't initiate until they get at least a couple of three rotations on the ball, give everybody a touch. And Dallin Bentley will initiate from the goal line. And the ball is nicked there by a UNR stick, but Andrew Bertha gains possession. Now back to Michael Perry. The midfielders will move to the restraining line. He gets a step back across to number 23. That's Johnson. That's a hit a UNR player, it looks like. Ball is still on the ground. And number 10, Alex Yost takes a shot, hits the pipe. And that'll be a turnover over to UNR. So Nevada clearing now. Ball goes back to the Cougars now as number 26, Devin Needs, wheels. Gets it over the midfield to number 16. And into Farley, shot, score. So a nice assist there by number 16, Braden Shoemaker. And gets it down to Farley, who finishes for the Cougars. Score 8-0 now as we're about 40% through the second period of play. Tanner Bean out there now for the Cougars on the faceoff. Looks like Coach Neck is going to stay with Tanner Bean here at least through the end of the quarter. And ball's free, and Chase Miller's got a beat on it. He picks it up. Chase Miller, the senior from San Ramon Valley High School in Alamo, California. Now up to Harry Wadhams is back in the game now, spelling for Michael Perry. Some movement. Boy, they had a midfielder free and they just didn't see him in time. Now back up to Zach Labrum. Max Nisser comes off and we'll get Chris Severson to get a complete first midfield line now. Steverson looks inside, cross field to Whitney, over to Tanner Johnson for the finish. Tanner Johnson at full speed coming around the crease. Gets that extra second step to glory and finishes that shot on the assist. Nice job by both Johnson and Labrum. On a quick offensive set there for the Cougars. Max Nesser struggling for the ball there. Ball still on the ground. UNR comes up with it. We'll get it behind to the goalie, Eddie Conley. Conley upfield. Good midfield pass. They'll work it downfield now and start their offensive set. Ball's at X for UNR. Bring it back up top. It's a shot and a save by Mason Moon. A rebound is picked up by the Cougars, number 33, Harrison Wardle. And the ball now on the stick of Moon and back to Wardle. Wardle, the MCLA All-American out of West Morris Mendham High School in Mendham, New Jersey. This is his senior year. And it's going to be a pass that's initially not controlled by the Cougars, but Harry Waddup's there to clean up the mess. And Tanner Johnson now, as the Cougars now will call timeout. We'll take a break here, and we'll be right back with you.
Oh,
back over to 55.
25 seconds.
25 seconds for Meckins in this 2-minute penalty on UNR.
15.
UNR trying to kill this. He's getting double teamed here as Boston Hanley comes from behind. There's Hanley, and he'll push him out of bounds. Ball is down, and Max Nesser has it now, and he'll get it to Mason Moon behind.
3, 2, 1, release.
Now up to the middle of the field to Connor Bernal. Now down to Max Ash and to Tanner Johnson. And we've got a timeout here for BYU.
Release.
Penalty is released, and we'll be right back with you.
8 seconds ago.
Cougars will be coming out of the timeout here in just a moment. Cougars now with a 14-0 lead on the University of Nevada, Reno. I think we had lost audio there for a moment or so. There was a 2-minute penalty on UNR for slashing, directing to the head, but Cougars unable to capitalize on that.
Trainer! 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 You're gonna get three of them. You better be dying.
Cougars start now with the ball at the restraining line. Now over to number 20, Dallin Bentley. Bentley now to number 25, Wadups. And now Michael Perry initiates. Gets it back to Wadups. Up top is number 7, Andrew Bertha. Turns inside to Bentley. Bentley's not open, so he's going to take it back behind to Michael Perry. That's an errant pass, but Perry will get that. Perry at X. And he's been told to go when he gets in that position. Turns back inside, looks up top. Gets it to number 20, Bentley. And Bentley had a stick clear for a moment, but a UNR defender got their stick in there just in time. And the ball goes out of bounds, but the Cougars are close on the shot. Michael Perry. Alex Yost now in the game for the Cougars, number 10. Back to Bertha. Bertha injured for the first 3 or 4 games of the season. Came back against Grand Canyon. And has been seeing a regular rotation since that time.
30 seconds! 30!
Hey, Perry! Behind you, Perry! Hey, not yet! Not yet! Hey, Perry, get high! Get high! Not yet! Not yet!
15 seconds remaining in the half.
10!
And Cougars initiating now. Michael Perry behind, looks up top, gets it inside. It's not handled by Yost, and that'll be the end of two periods of play with our score. BYU 14, Nevada 0. We'll take a break and be back with you in a couple of minutes.
The Y on the mountain is visible from miles away, welcoming you to Provo, home of Brigham Young University. For more than 30,000 students like me who live and study here, BYU is more than just a school, it's our home. There's no campus quite like BYU. It has the same feel of a small liberal arts college, along with all the same opportunities you have at a major university, all within a religious environment. I mean, there's so much to love about this place. Let's take a look around. So what Utah school ranks as a top-tier national university, a best value school, and a Money Magazine top 10? These are just a few of BYU's impressive national rankings. BYU is recognized for offering an exceptional undergraduate experience. The university has 10 colleges that offer undergraduate and graduate programs, including two prestigious professional schools. The nationally ranked J. Reuben Clark Law School was recently named Best Value Private Law School. And the highly respected Marriott School of Management has top 10 undergraduate and graduate programs. All across campus, undergraduate BYU students can be part of a multi-million dollar student mentoring program. A BYU education is about more than classroom learning. Whether they are conducting field research, working on an engineering team, or directing a film, students here get hands-on experiences and active learning opportunities.
We need to provide an education that allows our students not just to learn new things and to experience spiritual insights, but to become different, better people.
It's really great to live in a place where others respect your beliefs and share your values. BYU is sponsored by The Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, and Christian teachings are central to campus life. All faculty and students here commit to living the honor code and to living with integrity and character. So grab a chocolate milk and toast to the university that's proud to be at the top of the list of stone cold sober schools. Cheers. It's good, it's good. BYU is located at the base of the Wasatch Mountain Range, and this beautiful campus has something for everyone. Did you know that the Harold Bealey Library is ranked as one of the best college libraries in the country? From art and science museums, to BYU broadcasting, to labs and high-tech facilities, the BYU campus is truly a world-class educational environment. For students who enjoy the performing arts, BYU's award-winning performing groups share music, dance, and culture not only here on campus, but also internationally. One of the university's mottos is "The world is our campus." Did you know that BYU teaches more than 60 languages and 2/3 of BYU students speak a second language? Muitos dos estudantes, como eu, aprenderam a falar uma segunda língua enquanto serviram numa missão pela Igreja SUJ. BYU also has one of the largest study abroad programs in the nation, with programs in 55 countries. The university also has major international centers in London and in Jerusalem. BYU is not only about academics, it's also about having fun and enjoying life. On campus, students can enjoy a variety of activities, from comedy performances to concerts and more. The Wasatch Mountains draw visitors from all over the world in every season. The Provo area also has a progressive music scene, rooftop concerts, and other events that celebrate life and culture. From Olympians to All-Americans and national champions, BYU's athletic legacy gives us all a reason to rise and shout. This is an elite program. BYU student athletes on 21 men's and women's teams compete at the highest levels in Division I NCAA sports. BYU football is one of the country's legendary winning programs with devoted fans worldwide. Nothing beats spending time with 64,000 of your closest friends to cheer on the Cougars and be a part of this great campus tradition. A BYU education is a life-changing experience. As students, we're blessed to be a part of this great school and to share in the traditions of Brigham Young University. We'll never forget our time here as we carry the spirit of the Y throughout our lives.
I invite you to be part of this distinctive community where you can find your way, pursue your dreams, live your faith, and prepare to contribute to the world around you. Welcome to Brigham Young University.
The cougar lies in wait, ready to spring. One moment, calm, reposed. The next, dialed in. A single focus, a single mind, to come away with the prize. So is the life of a cougar. Ever on alert, always on the prowl. We are Cougar Nation, seizing the day.
Tom Campbell here back with you from Provo, Utah. We've got a score of 13-0 here. The Cougars in the lead as we coming out of halftime. Slug number 29, Tanner Bean, is going to face off for the Cougars. Number 25 for UNR. That's Felipe DeVerni. Bulk of this UNR team comes out of California. They've got a couple of Nevada residents, but at least all the starters are out of California high schools. While still in the middle of the field, as no one was able to pick it up, number 31 now with the ball for UNR, as he goes to X, being guarded by the All-American Harrison Wardle. An errant pass there, ball on the ground now for UNR. Knocked away by Max Messer. Ball still on the ground. Messer. And Max Ash is able to pick that up. He comes right down the sideline for the Cougars. Numbers here for the Cougars if they hurry. Into Messer. Oh, and Max Messer is not able to catch that ball. Very unfamiliar situation for Max Messer. Usually very good at picking up those crossfield passes. It's a goalie change for BYU, by the way. Number 40, Spencer Smith, now in for the Cougars, the freshman out of Copper Hills High School in Salt Lake City.
Jared Potter, you know Jared Potter. It's 38 over there. Far side depot.
Ball up top to the restraining line. Andrew Berth is there on the defense for the Cougars.
There we go, one! Number 7, he's the offensive side. He's got to be on the defense. He got stuck.
He goes back behind for UNR at the goal line extended. Moving the ball there at goal line extended, having difficulty with it. Now gets it back up to the top of the key. And ball is shot wide.
team, but the thing is, the kids, like, the kids on that team, both of those teams do really well.
Ball up top as UNR initiates. He'll take a shot, and that's wide. UNR there to back up, though, and ball will remain with the Wolfpack.
Charlie's in. No, they're freshman sophomore. Freshman sophomore.
Slow!
Up top, shot. Oh, and that's wide. Had a great opportunity to score there. But, number eight for the Wolfpack, unable to tee it up on the side of the goal there.
We don't need to slide there.
Back up top for UNR. Ball is down. Andrew Berth is going to battle for that. Try to push it without pushing him from behind. Ball still down. And Nesser's going to pick that one up. Ball gets downfield to number 32. Down inside to 47. Shot and score. Nice fast break goal for the Cougars. As number 47, Brandon Hall, or excuse me, number 47 for the Cougars, Tegan Wills, scores for the Cougars. As BYU now making some wholesale changes on their lineups as the second and third and fourth team players now getting an opportunity to play. Nothing our score here as UNR are able to get that face off. Get it back to the goalie Connolly. And they'll try to clear here. Nice upfield pass. It's going to be long though. But UNR able to recover that pass and successfully clear it on the Cougars. Around now as we've got Harrison Wardle covering on that defensively for the Cougars. Tegan Wells on the defense. Ball goes into the crease. The player wisely steps away from the crease. Into number 8 and 11 here, and that's a pickup there by our substitute goalie now in there. Spencer Smith makes his first save of the game. Smith did cleanup duty last week against Simon Fraser and did a fantastic job for the Cougars. Barvell now back to number 32 for the Cougars. That's Brandon Royce getting to see some playing time here. Bentley now at the restraining line for the Cougars. Dallin Bentley wheeling there, gets it to Alex Yost. Senior out of Oakton High School. Oh, and that's an errant pass from Alex Yost, and that'll be a turnover on the Cougars. So UNR's got the ball. They'll attempt to clear here. It's a downfield pass, and that's picked up, dropped first, and then picked up, and then there's an errant pass. It'll go out of bounds, and it'll be Cougar ball. Alex Yost over there to pick it up for the Cougars. No whistle yet. There's the whistle. And he'll get it back behind to the defense. And number 14, Ricky Rose, will start it from there. Back to Rose, cross field. That's a low pass. But Rose is able to handle. Sends it up to Spencer Smith, the goalie. Smith looks downfield and gets it to Alex Yost. Ball is knocked out of Yost's stick. He'll pick it back up. Pass it into number 36, Mash Ash. Ash is open. He'll look at the goalie, set it up. Crossfield pass, shot, and a goalie save. That's a nice save there by Conley for UNR. The stoppage of play. And the ball will go back to the Cougars. Yost back up top, first midfield line, now number 7. Andrew Bertha to Dallin Bentley. Royce, Brandon Royce, out on the attack now for the Cougars. It's a complete substitution now, the fourth attack line in for BYU. Yost inside to Bertha, back up top. That's an errant pass. That's going to go out of bounds, unfortunately. It is starting to rain here now, and, you know, the Cougars need to have their sticks come correct here with the rain. It's always an issue when the sticks start to get wet. It's sometimes difficult to make that pass that you usually are pretty comfortable with when your mesh on your stick is wet. That pass is intercepted. It's bounding around in front of the goal. And Bentley is trying to control it, still can't. Ball gets picked up now by number 27 for the Cougars, and that's thrown out of bounds. So you can see here that with the rain and a lot of people now getting their first opportunity to play here in the second half of the game, BYU struggling here to move the ball effectively. There's a shot and a goal for UNR, and their bench is ecstatic because they're on the scoreboard. And that's going to be an unassisted goal to number 11. And his name is Thomas Brookbrewer, I believe is the last name. So, UNR is on the board, folks. As we get about a quarter of the way through the third period of play. And that ball is going to go into the UNR end of the field, and it's going to be their ball. And they pull off all of their defensive middies, and they get a new midfield line on. Good opportunity here for the third and fourth string players for BYU to get some playing time against a good team. And have an opportunity to show the coaches some of their skills. Devin Nordgren down on the field for BYU at defense. Number 13, Spencer Taylor. Spencer Taylor's usually a starting defensive mini for BYU, but has been injured here the last couple of weeks and just coming back into play here today, seeing his first action. There's a push on the Cougars. That'll remain. Ball will remain with UNR.
We need to reset the balls on the UNR. Tuning match!
astray. And when I need it most, it breaks into a song that runs through all my veins and helps me to hold on. We'll be right back.
cougar lies in wait, ready to spring. One moment, calm, reposed. The next, dialed in. A single focus, a single mind, to come away with the prize. So is the life of a cougar. Ever on alert, always on the prowl. We are Cougar Nation, seizing the day.
Next game coming up here at BYU will be Thursday, April 6th against Colorado State. That'll be an RMLC league game. So you want to watch your calendar for that and make sure that you're here at North University Field. If you can't be here, we're going to stream it for you. I will not be here. I'll be out of town. But we'll find somebody who knows a thing or two about lacrosse and hopefully be able to give you some detail on what's happening on the field. BYU's got the ball moving well here on the man up. Up top to Bertha, shot. Oh, and a nice save by Conley. and BYU will retain possession. Pull up to number 7, Andrew Bertha at the restraining line. Connor Williams will come off. Dallin Bentley will go on. So got a full complement of offensive midfielders now for the Cougars. Tegan Willis up to Bentley, now over to Andrew Bertha. Looks like Wolfpack is going to get through this two-minute penalty without a score from the Cougars. Wagstaff up to Brandon Royce. Royce initiates from there. He's got a stick clear. He'll shoot and score. Nice job by number 32, Brandon Royce. Dodged and then stepped back and then re-dodged. Came through the restraining line and got a stick clear, time and room. And he'll put that ball by Conley to give BYU a 17-2 lead here in the third period of play. Flag goes down on the play. And that's number 49, Tyler Clancy. He took the hit to the face. And he's seems to be okay coming off the field in good shape.
Cougar lies in wait, ready to spring. One moment, calm, reposed. The next, dialed in. A single focus, a single mind, to come away with the prize. So is the life of a cougar. Ever on alert, always on the prowl. We are Cougar Nation, seizing the day.
Want to remind you that our next game will be coming up on April 6th against Colorado State. That'll be an RMLC league game. Make sure you make plans to be here with us here at North University Field. Or if you can't make it to the stadium, join us on the streamcast, which will be available to you. I want to thank all of our alumni who really came through. We really wanted to get some high-quality streaming equipment, and they stepped up, bought the computer, bought the software, bought the micro, they bought everything. So we're really appreciative to our alumni and parents who contributed to this purchase of the equipment for our webcast. As you can see from some of the presentation, this is professional equipment, and really happy to have it. And that's a shot from Haas. It's going to be wide.
It's Colorado State. Put this icon up for you so you make a mental note of that. And as far as the USU game, we're going to try to get that on the air for you as well. And so from Provo, Utah, this is Tom Campbell signing off. We'll see you next time here on the BYU Lacrosse YouTube channel.